Ladies and gentlemen, what you are witnessing right now is the recreation of a character originally created by a contestant of a recent original character contest that I personally hosted on my DeviantArt page from early January to the end of May of 2017. She placed in the contest, so for her prize, I have decided to take it upon myself to show her a videographed reenactment of me drawing her character, Helfer. If I recall correctly, I believe that is his name. But he looks like a heifer. And he is essentially a cartoonish character set in a fictitious world that this contestant who placed in my original character opened made. Her character design for that character was so good and so spectacular that she decided to give me the honor of trying to recreate that character in her art style. So that's exactly what I did. Folks, I'm not lying to you when I say, personally, that I'm getting better and better and better at this thing called digital art. Also notice how I made several errors as a result of my incomplete line art for said character. Of course, this caused the entire screen to turn into a certain color, except for the parts that were lined, that were outlined specifically. I later corrected this. So, Rikaku 19, if you're on YouTube and you're watching this video right now on my YouTube channel, guess what? You're in for an amazing treat. Because let me tell you, buddy, you earned this. You really did. You earned this. Absolutely, you did. So I figured that by posting this video of a sped-up version of me drawing your character and your style, I figured it would do your character and your art style a lot of justice. So, This is what I've decided to do. You're welcome. You can also, folks, find my artwork specifically on the skull31.deviantart.com/gallery. This is where you will find all of my stuff. I'm telling you, people, I'm a master at work when I want to be. And if I were making this up, I wouldn't be videographing this right now. And there you have it, folks. This is my finished product. A prize for my friend on DeviantArt, Rikafu19, for her placing in my original character open, which ended just a couple months ago at the end of May of 2017. You thought I was going to say 2017, didn't you? But anyway, that's it for now. Rikafu19. I seriously hope that you like this. If you don't like this, I'll understand. If you do like this, I'm all right with it too. Feel free to leave me some feedback with your thoughts. Thank you. Have a nice day. Ladies and gentlemen, what you are witnessing right here is a recreation of another one of my friend Rikafu19's characters. This one in particular is a troll named Matthew. Now, if I'm not mistaken, he has goat horns. And he also has a full-on beard and long hair. And he resembles the qualities of, say, a goat, especially at the bottom half of his body. Come to find out, though, you know, I think this turned out really, really, really well, considering how long it took me to do this. Of course, I started working at it at around maybe 5:30-ish, maybe 5 o'clock. I didn't finish it until around 8, if I recall correctly. Actually, I take that back. I recall finishing it at 8:30. So this took me about 3 hours, essentially, if you get what I mean. I mean, you get it, don't you? Also, notice the address of this particular picture, you know? Yeah, it's kind of explanatory in itself. Also notice how I made enough room to where I could fit the entire character in there. Notice the adjustments in size and stuff, and the way I positioned it. Yeah. But like I said, you know, I'm getting better and better at this with each passing day. Every day I'm getting better at it. And I don't even use Photoshop. I don't even use GIMP. I heard that GIMP was free, but I'm not sure about whether to believe it or not. But of course, that's up to me to decide. It's not up to anyone else. Of course, I have to decide whether to take their word for it or not. But, like I said, I do things like this on DeviantArt Muro because I can and I will. It is that simple, folks. That simple. There's just no other way to describe it. No other way to say it. Future legend in the making, folks. Yeah. Did I mention that the word folks sounds very, very similar to the F word? Although it doesn't have the UC, it has OL instead of UC. You know? But anyway, it is what it is. Regardless, you can't change fate, because fate is it's interchangeable. It's bound to change at any moment, because it can change itself in no time. Also notice what I did with the skyline. I made it pop with the skyline, didn't I? Oh, by the way, copy and pasted the entire image in a second later, and I edited the second layer in a way to make it look shaded. I'm not gonna tell you how, but I'll give you a hint. It has something to do with the adjustments column when it comes to DeviantArt Mural. So I'll let you figure that out for yourself, huh? I mean, how about it, huh? Think about it. And this, of course, is the final product. You see that? Real artistic genius. Genius! Look at that. That's an autistic artist at work, right there. Of course, I'm talking about myself, so don't get it twisted. Also, look at how I shaded this, especially on the second layer. Does that not look cool or what? But anyway, that's gonna do it for me here, so till we meet again. Later. took me the better half of around 2 hours to make. This is a digital commission for my friend Rikapu19, who placed in one of my more recent contests earlier this year. She told me to draw this particular character from, I believe, the Croods, if I remember correctly. That's Croods with two O's, not one U. Although it could be mistaken as such. I mean, people mistaken everything as some sort of a weakness for whatever reason because they think they're above God, but they're not. But that's beside the point. The point I'm trying to make at the end of the day is simple. When I'm willing to make something great, I can actually do quite well with it. And that's just saying, that's not really saying too much on my end, but I can say right now, this is literally it in a nutshell. This is me at my best. This is who I am. I proudly admit that I'm a human being. Oh, and here's the fast motion replay on this if you want to check it out. It's yours, my friend, but only if you have enough rupees. Faces of Evil reference. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Took me about 2 hours to make, maybe a little less. Probably a little less. Somewhere in the vein of maybe an hour and three quarters. So, yeah. But that's pretty much it. So long for now. Bye-bye.
This
of course, is her OC, Scrowl, if I remember correctly. I mean, not the best name in the world, but it works for her, so it works for me too, right? I mean, you gotta give her credit for the name. It stands out, it's original. And I personally like the name. Me personally. I like the character design too. Really good stuff. Hello.
No.
You got this?
Just some of that regular old life at the... semi-independent... living quarters. Yep, that's life, boy. Aw, come on now, y'all ain't seen nothing yet. That's my best, Al Jolson impersonation. Not that it matters, but... it totally doesn't matter. I could care less if it did. And I couldn't care less if it didn't. But you know, everything happens for a reason. Take a good look at this. Yeah, you see that? That is genius. But here's where things start to get better. This is where things start to get better. You know where things start to get better? Right around here? I mean, not that it matters, but who cares, right? Really, who cares? And now here's the special Neuro redraw. And in my style, of course. Which absolutely makes perfect sense. Because it does it a heck of a lot better on the Neuro app on my stash than it ever could on the actual deviation page, which is actually quite ironic now that I think about it. Very, very ironic, as a matter of fact. And it baffles me. It really does. It baffles me. I don't know why, but it baffles me. Also notice the outlining of the sky. You see that? Look at that. Beautiful sky, can't go wrong. And ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Bona fide genius. And now let's take a good look at it in slower motion, mind you. Good, good, good. Take a look. Yeah, just take a look. This was before I painted the sky. Before I painted the last mountain. Or in this case, I'd call it a valley. Yeah, you see that? Of course, I only started showcasing my art skills about maybe a month or two ago. I've proven pretty successful for the most part thus far. And needless to say, I don't regret it. I do not regret it. Not one bit. Not a bit. And that was before the shading. Take a look at what the shading looks like now. Seriously though, take a look. Take a good look. You see that? Genius. Well, not really, it's just me drawing digitally with a mouse built literally into my laptop. It's a square cursor pad thing. It acts as a mouse, a built-in literal mouse. Except it doesn't look like a mouse, it looks like a rectangle. With two other rectangles at the bottom. Kinda makes you wonder, doesn't it? Like looking at the hourglass. Half. Not half empty, not half full, but half. I mean, seriously. It is what it is. And now let's take a look at this at a slower motion. Check this. See that? I could go on with this. But, you know, I mean, it is what it is. You know what I mean? It just makes sense. So at the end of the day, everybody wins, nobody loses, we all go home happy. Right? You decide, isn't it? And it figures very much. And that's going to do it. So, for Skull Media Films, I am Kevin the Skull Anderson, and I will see you on the next go around. Bye bye. Say, you want to see something? See, for whatever reason, it's come to my attention that video that I posted of my Native American drawing for my friend Oliver Inc. isn't there. So I'm going to check my freaking DeviantArt page to see if I stored it there for whatever reason. I'll be back. And I just checked and it's not freaking there. Holy crap. You kidding me? Dang, man. I don't even know what I was thinking, to be honest. I don't think I want to know what I was thinking, because I don't make any sense anyway. To be honest. Now I'm just being blunt about it. Anyway, we're just gonna start from the beginning, work our way from there. Now, I had actually recorded a video of this earlier. I think I might have accidentally deleted it from all of my devices for some reason, because I'm stupid. And it's not that I want to be either, it's because I chose to be at that time. And it figures a lot. You know? And I just find it very bothersome. But anyway, I'm just going to take this time to vent. You know, here lately, I've been spending upwards of 2 hours or better working on abstract pieces and requests, some of which are prizes that I'm taking it upon myself to draw for people who placed in my contests this year in 2017. And that first one I submitted for my friend Oliver Ring, apparently I videographed it, but for whatever reason I didn't have the common sense to save it long enough on my computer to submit it to my video gallery on YouTube. Funny that, right? So yeah, kind of figures, doesn't it? You know? And to heck with everything else, what do I know? You know? So I'm going to pause this again. Going to check my you-know-what at you-know-where. There we go. Now let's just slow this down a bit. And there. Folks, I'm not lying to you when I said that I actually did record this before, but didn't have the common decency to upload it to YouTube or vid.me before deleting it. And you know what? That's probably because I didn't even think about it at that time. I was probably in a mad rush anyway, so I did the worst thing I could have possibly done. And it figures. A lot. Heck, I don't even know if it's on the freaking YouTube or vid.me. I don't even know if it's there or not. So I can only speculate and say that it is there, but for whatever reason, it's a private video. So it figures. So I'm just gonna go about it and say straight up, I don't care anymore. I don't care anymore. I don't care. You know, I really don't care anymore. And I'll tell you what really gets my goat. What gets my goat is the fact that all these people out there would rather choose to believe in a lie created by Satan himself than a truth that God's been trying every day for the last 142 millennia to get us to accept, knowing all too well that he gave us whatever freedom we had to make our own decisions because he trusted us to do right by him and get by. But what do? We mistake his trust for weakness. And that, my friends, is where everything goes to H-E double hockey sticks. That's another way of saying another word, but I'm not going to say it. Because reasons. Because people out there are too politically understandably correct to understand anything that's politically incorrect because reasons. And everybody knows what these reasons are. They understand what those reasons are, so I don't have to say it. Because they know. But so few actually want to accept it, and it saddens me, it sickens me, and it disturbs me, and it bothers me. And it irks me. And it ticks me off. And it really grinds my gears. And it gets my goat. And it sucks, and it blows. The list goes on and on how I describe it, but I'm just going to leave it at 9 or 10 for now, so, you know.
Hey, have you seen the latest news?
I really don't care about the news, man. What do you care about then?
You don't care about the news? Man, you need to see a therapist.
I don't need to see a therapist, man. You're the one that needs to see a therapist. Except the therapist that you should be seeing is the man upstairs.
Actually, for once, I totally agree with you.
Wait, you agree with this guy?
You know he's not wrong. He's as politically incorrect as incorrect can be. But, well, I don't even know if I said that right.
Don't worry about it, it's all good. Don't even worry about it. You're just fine. I go out there hunting for alligators, just like the old days. Maybe we should visit Louisiana again someday.
Actually, no, I like it better here in New York.
Really? How was that?
I really couldn't care less. So I prefer not to say. You know?
But you already know, so it's good. It's good. It's good.
Alright, so whatever reason, this thing ain't wanting to progress properly, so I'm just gonna do it fast and quick and get it over with. So here we go. Yeah. This is the fast and easy way. And I'm pretty sure that it sums up this video in about 60 seconds, give or take. Although I really couldn't care less at this point. Maybe I should care less.
Because, you know, the other 9.5 minutes were just filler.
Mm-hmm.
So you decided to cut it short then?
Yeah. Short and sweet.
Well, that's actually a pretty good idea now I've come to think about it, but I mean, it's not the best idea.
But it's not the worst, right?
Right. So I figures.
Also, just a confession to all of you people. I have way too much time on my hands, but I have the common decency to use that time properly. So, there you go. But I apologize that you had to sit through this other 9.5 minutes of filler, because I really could have just as easily summed it up in about...
I believe it's worth noting that this particular art video is brought to you by the letter C for common sense, or common logic, or common knowledge. Because if you don't have any one of those, your life just won't work the way it should.
sorry about the long freaking delay in between the start of this video and me starting to talk. Yeah. I mean, not that it matters, but you know. Anyway, let's get right down to it. This is the second of my art prizes that I have personally taken it upon myself to make for my good friend Olivery, who placed third in the digital section of my previous and recent contest earlier this summer in 2017. Of course, I did promise him and all the other contestants that anyone who placed would have a few art requests or commissions or whatever of their choosing. Whatever they want is okay with me, basically, and that's what I chose. Not to beat a dead horse here, but it is what it is. Besides that, I don't know what else. So I'm just going to leave it at that. Also keep in mind, and let's not forget one thing. This is by far, these series of videos that I'm doing are specifically subservient to the prizes that I'm going to give out to all the people who either participated or placed in my contests on DeviantArt this year. In fact, I don't even need to tell you where you can find me on there, because I have a few addresses on social media that you can go to. I mention a list of them on my YouTube channel description. I mention them on my DeviantArt page. You know, stuff like that. But only because I choose to. Not because I have to, but because I choose to. And not because I want a bigger audience either. I could care less about a big audience because, you know, the bigger audience you have, the more likely it is to offend someone. So, of course, the smaller audience you have, as long as it's not too small, the better. And the less likely it'll be for you to supposedly, I don't know, cause someone to go completely libtard on you. Yeah, I just said the word libtard. Get triggered all you want! Because quite frankly, I don't care anymore. Get triggered all you want, I don't care anymore. But back to the whole thing. You know, I spent a lot of time and effort on this. And let me tell you straight up, I'm not kidding when I say that this is by far a huge leap in terms of my creative evolution. Not just as an artist or a musician or a writer, but as a human being as well. So I should just keep that in mind and just get that out of the way, because you people need to know this stuff. Because if you go without knowing this stuff, you'll never know anything, right? I mean, it's just that simple. It's easy. It's simple to figure out, you know? By the way, I was looking at a series of browser-friendly screencasters and whatnot. You know,
apps that allow you to record using your computer screen, and of the many that I looked over, absolutely none of them appealed to me at all. So I decided, well, I'll just go back to doing what I know to do, and that's record with my Samsung. It's a smartphone, by the way. It's much better than an iPad or an iPhone or whatever. It's better than an iPad or an iPhone. So much better. Not only because of the fact that it's got fingerprint recognition, but it also allows you to make your own password, just like you would a computer. Or any other social media website that you join. Make your own password, as long as it meets a set criteria and stuff, and then you go from there, and that's that. Oh, look at this. I'm printing my signature via the drip paint tool. Keep in mind, I pretty much do all of my digital art on DeviantArt Mural. And I do many of my photo manipulations there as well. Sometimes I combine the two in such a way that causes people to I'm nuts, that I'm basically freaking nuts and crazy. I'm gonna go absolutely nothing but some crazy. I mean, not that it means a difference, but you know, screw it. It is what it is. And that, ladies and gentlemen, that is a work of art. So let's get through this one more time, shall we?
So here's what all I did.
Look at all this fast motion stuff, like a fast motion replay, because we need more of that. Yes, we do. Absolutely. 100%. Essentially sums up the 8.5 minutes that I took out of my day to record a slower version of this evolution of this particular picture in a nutshell, no less, in about 120 seconds. Not bad, huh? there you have it, folks. A masterful work. Yeah.
Thank you. Dinosaurs. We are the meteor. We are the Black Death. We are the bubonic plague. We are the death of our world. And it's all our fault.
Wrestling Jesus reference. So, this is the first of several contest prizes that I took it upon myself to do for a friend of mine who recently entered my first ever Maestro art contest this past spring and summer. And oddly enough, you know, her digital entries of Alondra de la Parra, Gustavo Dudamel, and Lorenzo Viotti were so perfectly drawn from a digital standpoint that I decided that she was worthy of the first place prize as far as the digital part is concerned. And I remember stating in a previous journal before the deadline that there would be four people placing for this contest, but in the journal explaining the results of said contest, of course, I went out of my way to essentially, well, I'll explain. What's so funny about it is that in this journal that I posted on the deadline of that contest, I decided, okay, you know what? There can't just be four winners, because I did allow the contestants to come up with both traditional and digital entries. So, of course, I created four prize places for both traditional and digital elements. And, of course, four winners from the traditional part were chosen. Four winners from the digital part were chosen. And, of course, I decided to take it upon myself to, well, quite frankly, do at least one digital abstract for every single one of the contestants in this contest. So I took it upon myself to do that. And what's so strange about this is every single one of the entries were equally good to some degree, and I couldn't simply just pick one, you know? Because what was the point? Really, what was the point? Seriously, though, think about it. And that's when I decided, okay, you know what? I'm going to do an abstract for everyone, which I'm going to display to you guys via my, you know what? I'm not going to tell you what it is because reasons, very obvious reasons that I'm not even going to try to explain. But anyway, back to the topic. See, this contest entrant won my digital part of the Maestro Art contest, and I asked her if there was anything I could draw for her, because I did promise the winner of both the traditional and digital parts of the contest to basically request a traditional commish or art request, as I don't draw traditionally anymore. And you know what? By allowing traditional commish prizes to be requested, I decided, okay, you know what? Maybe it's not such a bad idea after all to start drawing traditionally again. So, of course, that's what I did. That is what I took it upon myself to do. And let me just say straight up, I can't lie about it. There's no way for me to dispute it. And why should I dispute it? Really, though, why? Why should I dispute it? Because at day's end, it's not going to make a difference, right? So this, of course, is my digital photo manipulation / commission / request or whatever, you know? I actually took it upon myself. Look at all these layers. There's about 13 of them by my count. 13. I put an awful lot of work into this. About maybe, I'm going to say, 6 hours. Okay, I lied. At least 3 hours. If that at all. But I spent a considerable amount of time on this, and I did everything I could with it that I possibly could. And quite frankly, I don't regret it. And looking back, I can clearly say that this was the greatest thing, digital-wise, I've done in quite some time. Especially as an artist. So let's look at this again.
Let's look at this. Let's see what we got here. Yeah. Let's see what we got here.
So you see that? Genius. Pure genius. It's as genius as they come. Yeah. I mean, not that it matters or anything, but you people know what I'm talking about, so it's all good. And you know, the bottom line of it is actually quite simple. And at the end of it, at the same time, it's not that simple. So it's simple, but it's hard to understand. It's easy to accept, but it's difficult to fathom. And that's the problem. That's the problem with all of us. But you know, as I've said, I've taken a lot of time in making this at that time. You know, it was, I think it was about 2 months ago when I made this originally. And, you know, I spent a considerable amount of time on it and stuff, and yeah. But anyways, this is what resulted from this. Hours of constant ingenuity, and what we have here is straight up geniusness. Straight up emo geniusness at its core. If you can even call that. Not that there's a game show on GSN of a similar naming, you know, emo genius. That's basically the brother show of Idiot Test. Or is it the sister show? I forgot. But anyway, this is me giving everything I have in this. And I usually do things like this for 50 points apiece, or 20 or 30 points apiece, depending on what kind of digital artwork it should be, according to you. But, you know, things happen. They all happen for a reason. And of course, that is the final result. So I want to take this opportunity. Oh, by the way, I'm going to be doing this. This is just a preview of my complete Abstracttober experience, which I'm going to be compiling on Halloween at the end of this month and uploading to my YouTube channel personally the following day. Because I have freaking zero knowledge and logic whatsoever.
Beep. Thank you. things that are going on in this world that I'm pretty much not really capable of explaining at this time. Maybe I shouldn't explain these things for reasons I can't name or whatever, but basically, I'm going to show you all straight up my photo manipulation skills at their best. Look at this close to me. You may never see this again.
I mean, I don't know.
Start somewhat normal, you know, stuff like that, you know, and
Mario playing in the background for the win, stereotypical attack, oh man,
we're gonna have a good time, yes we are, gonna have such a good time, okay, ladies and gentlemen, what do we have here? Oh, by the way, that last bit, that was intentional. Especially this one. And when the last is first and the first is last, you'll be where you choose to end up, somewhere on the row of skids, and I don't know. Make what you want of it, I don't care.
I don't know that you guys know this or not, but I was actually in the process of making a credit skip that would serve as the outro to that video, that DVD that I mentioned earlier, that is scheduled to be released on my YouTube channel. No, nobody makes a difference. Nobody cares. You know? Nobody's gonna care. Nobody's gonna watch this. It's not gonna matter to them. It's not gonna make a difference at this point. Should it make a difference at this point? I don't know.
We're gonna go live!
Do you want to know what happens? Do you want to know what happens when you call Chris Jericho a stupid idiot?
Well, it does make sense now, doesn't it? Okay, so they side with the white woman, but they crap all over the black woman. Figures. That's the way it's always been. And figures, because there are a lot of people in this world that say that Americans are the stupidest people on the entire planet. But they're only part of the way right. They're also the smartest, the most gifted, the most talented, the most prodigious, the hardest working in some cases, depending on which state you live in. I mean, I don't know. You make what you want of it.
But yeah, that sums it up right there.
See y'all later. It was made in DeviantArt Mural, but DeviantArt Mural crashed for whatever reason, because reasons that I can't discuss, obviously. But we all know what they are, so it's good. It's all good. All good.
That was a lie.
What just even happened?
Yeah. another day in the life. That's all it is, man. Just another day in the life. Ain't not gonna make a difference no more. Not gonna make no difference anyway, man. Yeah. Just weird. Okay. Yeah, it's just the Dropbox. Dropbox is out again. Router's all faulty and whatnot. I don't know, man. Make what you want of it. Just to be truthful about it.
I don't even care.
A whole lot of sense to me. I mean, not that it matters, but what gives? I mean, seriously, what gives?
Nobody knows no more.
Already naturally like that. I got a 500 gigabyte hard drive on my own one of these.
Why in the world would anybody want to pay $2,500 for two laptops that might not even work? I mean, come on, man. That is ridiculous
right there.
A brand new CD. A brand new car.
You call that a car or call it a CD? actually not that hard. There's like a 1 in 8 chance of actually winning it, right? So it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Dun 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 dun